In preparing for the first market update of 2017, I thought I better dress for success. So of course, I've worn one of my favorite cufflinks. They're little compasses if you can't see. My wife gave them to me, probably because I'm one of those men that never asks for directions. But it reminds me how one navigates. And today is all about how do you navigate the 2017 market. And I want to talk about the difference between predictions and trends. I love predictions, but I don't think they're the best to understand today's current market. The only prediction I'm going to give you is one you may have read in a recent article from the Sarasota Herald Tribune. It talked about really the region, and the region is positioned for long-term success. We see that in people moving here. The West Coast, as you know and I know if you've lived here, is a magical place. And over the last year alone, over 20,000 new residents now call Sarasota, Manatee, and Charlotte County home. So what does that mean in terms of our buyers and sellers, and of course, home values? Well, there I want to switch to trends. And I want to start by going back to really that recovery years starting in 11 and 12. And if you were a home buyer or seller, you would have realized really from 2012 up through 15, we were in a fast-paced recovery. We were seeing increases in average price. We were seeing increases in unit sales. And that trend really brought us back to a much healthier market coming into 16. So let's talk about the 2017 trends that I think are going to shape our market. Really, there are two things that I want to talk about first. One is new construction. So it's no surprise that buyers want it to feel new or be new. And so if you are looking at selling your house, you're going to have to ask your real estate professional, am I competing with new construction? The other major trend is really months of supply. We know that really coming through the recovery phase and going back almost to where it was most acute, if you were looking for a property in 2015, you were really in a seller's market. Today, with inventory approaching 6 months, it's either a balanced or moving into a buyer's market. That means the buyer has more control over dictating price than sellers will. Now, that's not everywhere. Every market is unique and every section of a market is unique, but I think that's an important macro trend for our three-county area. And finally, I want to talk about the luxury end of the market. Everybody wants to know what's happening in the million-plus market. So in the million-dollar market, where we've seen the greatest activity is really when prices have been adjusted to meet the current buyer mindset. Now, if you're a seller, what you're going to be asking is how much of my condition, location, or my competition, particularly with new construction, is affecting my price strategy. We know that once things are brought in line, they sell. But it is a market that is adjusting, and I think it's a market that takes constant conversation to achieve your goals. It's been a pleasure to give you the first update of 2017, and I look forward to more news as we move through the year.